الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا، صدق الله العظيم. عن عمران بن حسين رضي الله تعالى عنه قال: سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول: ما بين خلق آدم إلى قيام الساعة أمر أكبر من الدجال. رواه مسلم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. Respected brothers, respected elders, mothers and sisters listening at home, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed the ummah of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The ummah of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the only community that has the power to stand in front of something that is false. The ummah of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the only community that can face any form of fitna, withstand that fitna. The greatest ni'mah is iman. No community, no culture, no religion, no society can compete with the believers. Why? The simple reason is that because they lack in iman. The greatest power is iman. Without iman, Allahu Akbar Kabira, a person, an individual has nothing. Iman is asal. Iman is the basis of why an individual is living. That is why Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned in the hadith that مَثَلُ الْحَيِّ الَّذِي, that person who is alive and that person who is not alive, dead, the difference is of the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The person who does zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is alive. And the greatest zikr is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. That is the greatest zikr. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned in the hadith, the greatest fitna the world will ever experience is the fitna of Dajjal. Nothing can be compared with Dajjal Akbar. Many have been Dajjal, many have come and gone, but the title given to the Dajjal that is mentioned in the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Ad-Dajjal al-Akbar. Here we have a hadith kitab where the title is given, Ad-Dajjal al-Akbar, the biggest of the Dajjal, the father, the leader of all the Dajjalun, Kazzabun, Dajjal al-Akbar. Nothing can compete with the fitna that Dajjal will present to the people at that time. Allahu Akbar. In the hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned from Adam alayhi salatu wa salam to Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, every single prophet has warned their ummah, their community of the coming of Dajjal. The hadith which I read in khutbah is narrated by Hazrat Imran bin Hussein radiyallahu ta'ala an. He says that سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَقُولُ, I heard from Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke to us. This hadith is in the Muslim of Imam Muslim rahmatullah alayhi. He said that مَا بَيْنَ خَلْكِ آدَمَ إِلَىٰ قِيَامِ السَّاعَةِ أَمْرٌ أَكْبَرَ مِنَ الدَّجَّالِ. Our sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, from the time of Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, from the time when he was created until the day of Qiyamah, nothing will be more monstrous for insan than the coming of Dajjal. We talk about Dajjal, Allahu Akbar Kabira. We don't want to be there in the way of Dajjal, my respected brothers. Nothing of the sort. One cannot even experience or even picture who this man Dajjal might be. Subhanallah al-Azim. Allahu Akbar. Aap sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith has instructed the ummah. He has given us discipline. What are we to do when we hear this breaking news? Dajjal is out. When you hear this news for the first time, Dajjal is out. What are we to do? Again, Hazrat Imran bin Hussein radiallahu ta'ala an is the narrator of the hadith. He says, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَنْ سَمِعَ بِالدَّجَّالِ. When any one of you hears of Dajjal, فَلْيَنَأْ مِنْهُ. Don't cross his path, don't go close to him, but stay very, very far away from him. Don't feel confident that because you have Iman, you will be protected from the fitna of Dajjal. Of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I said, فَوَاللَّهِ. Allah's Prophet has taken qasam, an oath. إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَأْتِيهِ. A Muslim, a believer, will come to him. وَهُوَ يَحْسَبُ أَنَّهُ مُؤْمِنٌ. And he will feel protected, thinking that I have Iman. Who is Dajjal? I have heard of Dajjal. The ulama have explained to us the story of Dajjal. He cannot harm me. وَهُوَ يَحْسَبُ أَنَّهُ مُؤْمِنٌ. He will think he has Iman, he is a mu'min. فَيَتَّبِعُهُ. But the glitter, the magic that Dajjal will present to him, in front of him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that I fear that he might become part of that Dajjalic system. He might become the follower of Dajjal. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. The name says it all. Imam Muhammad Mahdi. Mahdi means the one who is guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the word Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. Ihdina Mahdiyun. And the name given to this individual, Ad-Dajjal al-Akbar, who will be a human being, he won't be a monster. Very much disfigured, very powerful, short, strong, full of hair. But he will be a human being. In fact, Dajjal al-Akbar will be a Jew. Who will he be? A Jew, from the Jewish origins. In the hadith, the muhaddithin have mentioned that Dajjal will be a Yahudi. Yahudiyun nasl. Like how Imam Mahdi will be Arabiyun nasl, will be an Arab. Dajjal Akbar will be Yahudi. Allahu Akbar. Aw sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, when you hear of him, you turn away from him. The name given to him is Dajjal, because in the Arabic language, Dajjala means to deceive someone. Kisi ko dhoka dena. Deception. Master of disguise will be Dajjal. Allahu Akbar. Dajjal, the greatest one. The greatest person who will deceive all sorts of people, everyone. That is why majority of the people, today we call the Jewish community, an intellectual community, that are holding everything when it comes to economy. But that will be the army, the backbone of Dajjal, as mentioned by Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given us every detail of Dajjal, how he will look like. In fact, in the hadith, our sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, no prophet has ever described Dajjal like how I, Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has described Dajjal to you. So be very careful when he comes. Recognize him. Make sure you are firm, your Iman is strong when he comes. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Hazrat Ubadah bin Samit radiallahu ta'ala is the narrator of the hadith. He says, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to us, the companions were sitting, إني حدثتكم عن الدجال حتى خشيت أن لا تعقلوا. I want to describe Dajjal to you to its minute detail, so there is no difficulty in recognizing him when he comes. This is Rahmat. This is Shafqat of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just imagine the ilm of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had. Physically describing everything of Dajjal, absolutely everything of Dajjal. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَنَّ الدَّجَّالَ كَثِيرٌ تِنْغْنَا هُوْغَا. He will be very short. أَخْجَهُ جَعَدٌ أَعْوَرُ مَتْمُوسُ الْعَيْنِ لَيْسَدْ بِنَأْتِيَةٍ وَلَا حَجْرَا. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the legs will be curved in. The legs of Dajjal will be curved in. The hair on his head will be very, very hard. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that he will only see with one eye. Only with one eye. Ahmad Thompson has written a book in which he comes up with the idea what Dajjal is. A lot of people have different ideas of Dajjal, which in a way they might be right, but we cannot sort of take the literal meaning of describing Dajjal as what they have described. For an example, he has said that TV is Dajjal. TV, the screen, the one-eyed Dajjal. That is part of the Dajjalic system, but it is not the Dajjal that Abu Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has mentioned. The Dajjal is someone who will come. The Dajjal is Yahudi Yunasan. Dajjal will travel. Abu Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has described Dajjal in the hadith. He is a human being. Abu Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said that he will see with one eye, he will be blind with the other eye. Even the eye that is blind, that eye is described in the hadith of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Abu Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said that eye will be like a squashed grape. Like a squashed grape. That is how the second eye will be. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warns the ummah, فَإِنْ أُلْبِسَ عَلَيْكُمْ فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ رَبَّكُمْ لَيْسَ بِأَعْوَرٍ. Even now, if you are in doubt of Dajjal, then remember your Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not a'war, he is not blind. The reason why Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had to say that is because in the early stages of Dajjal, Dajjal will claim to be a king first. Then slowly, he will say he is a prophet. And then finally he will say that he is God and everyone should worship him. He will force people to worship him. Allahu Akbar. That is just one sign of Dajjal. Another sign of Dajjal is mentioned in the hadith of Hazrat Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu is the narrator. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ala uhaddithukum hadithan ad-dajjal ma haddasa bihi nabiyun qawmahu. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the companions, shall I tell you about such a thing which no prophet has spoken of regarding Dajjal? Innahu a'war, he can only see with one eye, he is blind with the other eye. The second main sign of Dajjal will be that he will put up a good act, he will put on these two ludicrous shows for people. Two shows, two sessions. وَأَنَّهُ يَجِيءُ مَعَهُ بِمِثْلِ الْجَنَّةِ وَالنَّارِ فَالَّتِي يَقُولُ أَنَّهَا الْجَنَّةِ هِيَ النَّارِ وَإِنِّي أُنْزِرُكُمْ كَمَا أَنْزَرَ بِهِ نُوحٌ قَوْمَهُ رَوَاهُ الْبُخَارِ وَالْمُسْلِمِ. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said he will put up two shows for the people. One he will show Jannat and the other show will be of Jahannam. When he walks, people will see with him Jannat and Jahannam, the picture that will be given. And he will say to everyone, if you believe in me, Jannat is for you. If you don't believe me, I will throw you in this Jahannam. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you are in the way of Dajjal and if you see Jahannam, the fire that the Dajjal puts in front of you. If need be, jump into that fire, because that fire will be Jannat. And the Jannat which he will show and display will be Jahannam. Two signs. And this is the main sign of the Dajjal. When he walks, he will have with him Jannat and Jahannam. Jannat and Jahannam. This is the picture. And it is nothing too hard for us to believe in the time that we are living in, my respected brothers. Today, we have TV. We can see even mobile phones now. You can talk with someone and you can even see that person who you are talking with. Fly with Emirates and every seat will have a miniature TV there. If insan can do that, technology, what about the power of Dajjal, the greatest magician which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him power? It is mentioned in the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another clear sign of Dajjal, the most clear, his identity will be, as sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned in one hadith, it is narrated in a way that in between the two eyes, three Arabic letters will be printed, in between the two eyes. You will have a gap in between the two eyes. In another hadith, Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that it is printed on the forehead of Dajjal, three Arabic letters, Kaf, Fe, and Re. The muhaddithin have mentioned every literate and illiterate person will have the power to read the three Arabic words, Kaf, Fe, Re. That will be his identity. The seal of kufr. The seal of kufr. When he walks, he will have that sign. The seal of kufr. Like how the Jews in the time of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Madinatul Munawwara, when Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made hijrah, all the Jews were desperate to see the physique of Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because in the Torah, the Kitab revealed to Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu was salam, the entire description of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was there. One of the descriptions given in Torah was with regards to Mahre Nabuwat, the seal of prophethood. The seal of prophethood. And that was in between the two shoulders of Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the back. That was the mu'jiza of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which was written in the Arabic way of Muhammad Rasulullah, which is known as Mahre Nabuwat, the seal of prophethood. Hazrat Sa'id bin Yazid radiallahu ta'ala an, a young companion, at that time he was only 9 years of age. He is the narrator of the hadith. He says that one day my auntie took me to Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She said to Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that this is my nephew and he is always ill. He is always ill. O Prophet of Allah, make dua for him that Allah cures him. Shifa dene wala kaun hai? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Cure comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam has mentioned in the Quran. وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينِي. When I am ill, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives me shifa. The dua is something else. Shifa comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a 9-year-old boy, with great love, brushed his auspicious hand on the head of Hazrat Sa'ib bin Yazid radiallahu ta'ala. Hazrat Sa'ib was 9, as mentioned. And he says that Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the companion, bring one bowl of water for me and I will make wuzu. Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made wuzu. And the water with which the body parts were washed was collected by the companions. And Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Hazrat Sa'ib bin Yazid to drink that water. When Hazrat Sa'ib bin Yazid radiallahu ta'ala drank from that water, he said that I was cured instantly. Hazrat Sa'ib bin Yazid. But to follow on with that hadith, in that hadith, which is mentioned in the Shama'il of Imam Tirmizi rahmatullah alayh. Hazrat Sa'id bin Yazid radiallahu ta'ala says that I was only 9 years of age and I saw the back part of Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He had a chadar on. I could see clearly the mohr, the seal of prophethood, which was written as Muhammad Rasulullah. So the seal of prophethood with Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was something different. And the seal that was given to Dajjal is known as the seal of kufr. Every single individual will recognize him. And that is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Recognize him. Recognize that. Look at the forehead, kafe and re, and stay away from him. Allahu Akbar. He will only remain in this world for only 40 days. But the havoc, the mischief in that 40 days, he will travel the whole world. Each and every city he will visit, even Leicester. He will come everywhere. Allahu Akbar. When we look at the history, Islamic history, Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala in Khilafah, 10 years. And how hard Hazrat Umar Farooq worked. We have to compare how Dajjal will be. In 40 days he will travel everywhere. He will visit every country and every city. Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala, from the first day of Khilafah given to him, he lived in Madinatul Munawwara at that time. The historians have said that on every day for 10 years, Muslims conquered 274 square miles of land, and Hazrat Umar Farooq would annex that to Madinatul Munawwara. Every day, 274 square miles of land for 10 years on average. No one can be compared with Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala. In 10 years, the historians have said, Hazrat Umar Farooq conquered 36,000 cities and towns. 36,000 cities and towns. Where are we, my respected brothers? How much effort have we done? He built himself with his own money 4,000 masajid, Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah al-Azim. Sitting in Madinatul Munawwara. In fact, when Abu Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam performed his Hajj, with Abu Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, there were 125,000 companions. From the demise of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, 25 years after the demise of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Islam, Allahu Akbar, the banner of Islam in one direction was from Arabia to Spain, and in the other direction from Sindh to Samarkand. And if you look at the history books, I was looking at it today with the olden maps that are there. Alexander the Great, it took him 100 years to conquer all that area. As Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala and conquered everything within only 10 years. From Sindh to Samarkand, from Arabia to Spain. Subhanallah al-Azim. Only after 25 years from the demise of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then came the Mongols in the leadership of Jahangir Khan, the ruthless person, with one thing in mind. We cannot even compare the Crusaders with Jahangir Khan and his army, the Mongols. Again, on the subject of Ya'juj and Ma'juj, where will they come from, inshallah, after the discussion of Dajjal Akbar, we will go on to Gog and Magog, Ya'juj and Ma'juj, where they are. The Mongols came with one thing in mind, to wipe out Islam, and they were successful. They attacked every single Islamic city. They attacked Baghdad. Baghdad has always been there, forefront. They attacked Baghdad for 40 days. Every single Muslim Iraqi at that time was killed. All the Muslim libraries were burnt. Anyone who was alive was treated worse than an animal slave. Worse than that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Hakim. The same Mongols who came out from Mongolia to destroy Islam, and they were successful. They destroyed the whole of Islam, the Islamic civilization at that time. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them hidayat, and every single one of them embraced Islam. And they were the same people again who conquered all the different parts and annexed it to the Islamic empire, making tawbah and istighfar of what they did. That is the hikmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. What we think, what we see, something different. Tribulation. We have good days and then we have bad days. Again, when the Dajjal will come, that will be a difficult moment. Then Ya'juj, Ma'juj will come. That will be a difficult moment. But after Ya'juj and Ma'juj, Isa alayhi salatu wa salam will remain in this world for 40 years. And at that time, not a single kafir, everywhere in the world will only be Muslims. Everyone will be Muslim. So that is the good day that we are looking forward to. But before that, the Dajjal and Ya'juj and Ma'juj comes. But we have to make sure that we stay united in a group. In a group. We have no power, no capacity to attack any one of them individually. In the hadith it comes up, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned, the strongest person at that time of Iman will be that person who will be a Madani from Madinatul Munawwara. The Dajjal will have the power in 40 days to make a visit everywhere except for Makkah Mukarrama and Madinatul Munawwara. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha narrates a hadith. She says that at that time in Madinatul Munawwara there will be 7 entrances by which one could enter Madinatul Munawwara. 7 entrances. I don't know how many entrances there are right now, but in the hadith it is mentioned 7 entrances. When the Dajjal will camp behind the outskirts of Madinatul Munawwara at every entrance, Aisha says that there will be 2 angels protecting and guarding the gates at that time, entrance. When he will be camping outside Madinatul Munawwara, all the munafiq that will be even in Madinatul Munawwara, Arabian Peninsula at that time, will join the Dajjal, will join him when they see him. But one from the believer will go to the Dajjal. All of the kuffar will be there with the Dajjal, and this believer will go and stand in front of the Dajjal. And he will say, I testify that you are the same Dajjal which Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had mentioned in the hadith. You are a kafir. The Dajjal will look at him and will laugh. He will have a massive army. Massive army, all outside. And the final battle that will take place will be in Sham, all this area. Syria, Baytul Muqaddas, Jerusalem, where we have Tel Aviv. All that area. That is the final battle. That man will go, that believer. In the hadith of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given glad tidings that he will have the highest degree of Iman at that time. He will stand in front of the Dajjal and he will say, you have no power over me. The Dajjal will laugh at him and he will take out something to the effect we can describe as a sword. And he will say to the people, if I slay him, one side will fall on the left and the other on the right hand side, and I will make him alive again. I will put ruh inside him. Will you believe me? All the kuffar, the army will say, we will believe you, we do believe you. And again, subhanallah, he will slay the mu'min, one part will fall on the left hand side, the other on the other side. And then again the power will be given to him, he will be a magician. That mu'min will become alive again. After that the believer, the mu'min will say to him, now the level of Iman has increased. This is what exactly Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam had mentioned in the hadith. Now you don't have power to kill me for the second time. And the Dajjal will try again to kill him, but he will not be successful. But he is the only person mentioned in the hadith who will have a very, very high degree of Iman. But for the general public, the historians, for people that are here, our duty is when we hear of Dajjal, we are not to go to his direction. We are to go to the opposite direction, looking for Imam al-Mahdi, and might as well join him. Even Imam al-Mahdi, he knows what will happen exactly. He is a buzrug, he is a wali. Inspiration will come to him in the heart. He will take the Muslim forces towards Sham. The final battle takes place in Syria. And Syria is also known as Mahshar, where everyone will be accounted for. All the actions. Hazrat Imam al-Mahdi will be in the masjid. All the believers will be on one side. The Dajjal will, Allahu Akbar, put a siege in that entire area, covering the Muslims from all four sides. Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will come down. After performing salah, the Dajjal will not know that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam has come. After performing salah, everyone will fear the Dajjal, the power that he will have, a massive army. Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will say, open the door of the masjid. And Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will be there in front, from the inside part of the masjid. And right in front of him will be the Dajjal. When the Dajjal sees Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, he will start to run. Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will chase him. It is said in the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam, like how salt dissolves in water, that is how he will melt away. Allahu Akbar, disintegrates. Khatam ho jayega. It is said in the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam that Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will kill him at the point of Maqam-e-Lud. Maqam-e-Lud. Maqam-e-Lud is known as, I think, Lida now. And Maqam-e-Lud today is in Tel Aviv, where the international airport of Tel Aviv is. That is where Maqam-e-Lud is. And that is the point where Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will come and he will kill the Dajjal. Great, great fitna. On the subject of Dajjal, has anyone seen Dajjal? One companion in the hadith is mentioned, whose name is Hazrat Tamim-e Dari radiallahu ta'ala. Hazrat Tamim-e Dari radiallahu ta'ala was a Christian who aslama, he embraced Islam. He is the first one to put a chandelier in Masjid-e-Nabwi. The first one to put chandelier in Masjid, Hazrat Tamim-e Dari radiallahu ta'ala. He surprised Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam by beautifying the Masjid. A lot of the people say, oh, Masjid-e Umar, too flashy. Too flashy. But the own homes are flashy. That is not fuzul kharchi. But the house of Allah becomes flashy. Beautiful cars are not flashy. But Masjid-e Umar is flashy. The 40,000 pound extension kitchen in the house is not flashy, but Masjid-e Umar is flashy. Three cars are not flashy, but Masjid-e Umar is flashy. The four minarets are flashy. The beautiful roof is not flashy. Allahu Akbar Kabir. Subhanallah Azim. I was thinking, it's all corrupted. When you look at Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala and how he worked hard to beautify Masjid-e-Nabwi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hazrat Tamim-e Dari gave a surprise to Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Beautiful lamp chandelier was there. Hazrat sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, who put this chandelier? Hazrat Tamim-e Dari thought, Hazrat sallallahu alayhi wa sallam might get angry and he looked down and said, Ya Rasulullah, Ana. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to him, O Tamim, if I had daughters available, vacant, all the daughters of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam were married, two were given to Hazrat Asman, one to Hazrat Ali, one died very early, four daughters. Hazrat Tamim Dari was there. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to him, Tamim, I am so happy for you beautifying the Masjid Nabwi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If I had a daughter, I would marry my daughter to you right now. Subhanallah. Kitne bade sahabi honge. How powerful his position must be. And he was a Christian. Wa aslama. And he embraced Islam. So in the hadith, Hazrat Fatima bint Qais is the narrator of the hadith. She says that Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told all the companions together in the masjid, he performed salat. After performing salat, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had an asa. He sat on the minbar, وَهُوَ يَضْحَقُ. And Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was smiling. فَقَالَ الْيَرْزَمْ كُلُّ إِنسَانٍ مُسَلَّهُ. All the companions must be seated. Nobody should go out from the masjid. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to the companions, هَلْ تَدْرُونَ لِمَا جَمَعَتُكُمْ. قَالُوا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ عَالَمٌ. Do you know why I have assembled all of you here in masjid? In the masjid, the companion says, Allah and His Messenger know best. قَالَ إِنِّي وَاللَّهِ مَا جَمَعَتُكُمْ لِرَغْبَةٍ وَلَا لِرَغْبَةٍ. I have not gathered you in the masjid for distributing wealth, booty, or for jihad. وَلَكِنْ جَمَعَتُكُمْ لِأَنَّ تَمِيمَ الدَّارِ كَانَ رَجُلًا نَصْرَانِيًا. I have only gathered you because here you see Tamim al-Dari كَانَ رَجُلًا نَصْرَانِيًا. He was a Christian, فَجَاءَ, and he came to me, وَأَسْلَمَ, and he became a Muslim, and he has got something to tell me. Why did he become a Muslim? What has he got to say to me? And Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was smiling. وَحَدَّثَنِي حَدِيثًا. And he spoke to me, وَافَقَ الَّذِي كُنْتُ أُحَدِّثُكُمْ بِهِ عَنِ الْمَسِيحِ الدَّجَّالِ. Which confirms to what I have related to you regarding Dajjal. Hazrat Tamim Dari is saying, حَدَّثَنِي أَنَّهُ رَكِبَ فِي سَفِينَةٍ. He boarded a ship for sea voyage, بَحْرِيَّةً مَعَ ثَلَاثِينَ رَجُلًا. With 30 people on board from the tribe of Lakham and Juzam. فَلَعِبَ بِهُمُ الْمَوْجُ شَعْرًا فِي الْبَحْرِ. They faced a strong storm for 1 month, and because of that strong storm pushed them out from their destination, and they came to this remote island. فَدَخَلُوا الْجَزِيرَةَ. And they, when they entered that island, فَلَقِيتُهُمْ, they saw something that resembled to an animal in front of them. كَثِيرُ الشَّعَرِ, full of hair. لَا يَدْرُونَ مَا قُبُلُهُ مِنْ دُبُورِهِ. They did not know what was the front part and what was the back part of that animal. And the companion said to him, قَالُوا وَيْلَكِ مَا أَنْتِي. Who are you? What are you? قَالَتْ أَنَا الْجَسَّاسَ. And he said that I am the spy of Dajjal. انْطَلِقُوا إِلَى هَذَا الرَّجُلْ فِي الدَّيْرِ فَإِنَّهُ إِلَى خَبَرِكُمْ بِالْأَشْوَاقِ. I am a spy for Dajjal. Enter this temple. There is a man waiting for you. Eagerly he is waiting for you. قَالَ لَمَّا سَمَّتْ لَنَا رَجُلًا فَرَّقْنَا مِنْهَا أَن تَكُونَ شَيْطَانًا. When that Jassasa spoke to us, we fear that maybe inside the temple there is a jinnat, a shaitan waiting for us. We feared, but we had no choice. We were on the island. فَانْتَلَقْنَا سِرَاعًا. We entered the temple. حَتَّى دَخَلْنَا الدَّيْرِ. And we saw inside the temple someone who we had never seen before. They saw a mighty strong-bodied man. Never saw such a man before. His hands were tied to the neck, and his left leg from knee to ankle were tied up with strong iron chains. And the companion said to that person, who are you? And that person replied, you must be knowing at least something about me. You must be knowing at least something about me. Tell me who you are. He's asking the companions, tell me who you are. The companions spoke to him and they said that, نَحْنُ أُنَاسٌ مِنَ الْعَرَبِ. We are people from Arabia. And he said, Hazrat Tamim Dari spoke to him, gave him the full information, why they came, how they got there. And then Dajjal, that was Dajjal by the way, and he started to speak with Hazrat Tamim Dari radiallahu ta'ala an. He says, أَخْبِرُونِ عَنْ نَخْلِ بِسْطَانِ هَلْ تُسْمِرُوا. tell me, are there still dates on the trees of Bisat? Are there still dates on the trees of Bisat? Bisat is a city in Syria. And the companion says, Naam, there are still dates on the trees of Bisat. And he said that a time will come that there will be no dates. The second question put forward was that, is there still water in the river of Tabariya? And the companion said, yes, there is a lot of water in the river of Tabariya. He said, a time will come when there will be no water in the river of Tabariya, that is in Iraq. And then the Dajjal said to them, he spoke to them regarding the water in the springs of Zumar. Zumar again is in Syria. And is water used by the farmers from the springs of Zumar? The companion says, yes, there is still water in Zumar and the farmers still use that water. And then after that, the Dajjal spoke to Hazrat Tamim Dari and the 30 people that were there. He said that, أَخْبِرُونِ عَنْ نَبِيِّ الْأُمِّيِّينَ, tell me of the unlettered prophet. Has he come to Makkah Mukarramah? Has he been born? If he has been born, قَدْ خَرَجَ مِنْ مَكَّةَ وَنَزَلَ يَسْرِبْ, has he migrated to Yathrib? Yathrib is the old name of Madinatul Munawwara. Hazrat Tamim Dari radiallahu ta'ala and said to Dajjal that na'am, he has migrated to Madinatul Munawwara. And he says, أَقَاتَلَهُ Arab? Have the Arabs opposed him, fought with him? قُلْنَا na'am. They said, yes, they fought with him. قَالَ كَيْفَ صَنَعَ بِهِمْ, what is the condition now? Hazrat Tamim Dari radiallahu ta'ala and said that slowly the Arabs have accepted him and they are following him. The Dajjal at that time said to Hazrat Tamim Dari and the Jama'at that was with him that it is khair for them to follow Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ata'uhu. Amma inna ذَلِكَ khairun lahum an yuti'uhu wa inni mukhbirukum anni. In the hadith now he is saying to the Jama'at that was there, now I shall tell you who I am. Ana al-Masihud Dajjal. I am Masihud Dajjal. He's in a remote island somewhere. Wa inni yushiku an yu'zana li min al-khuruji fakhruj, and I'm waiting when permission will be given to me to come out from this island. For asiru fil ard, I will travel everywhere. Fala ada'u qaryatan, I will not leave even one city behind. Illa habbatuha, I will enter every single city and village. Fi arba'ina laylatan, in 40 nights. Ghayra makkata wa tayyiba, except for Makkah Mukarrama and Tayyiba. Tayyiba is the name of Madinatul Munawwara. Muharramatani alayya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made that haram on me. Kullama aradtu an adkhula wahidan minhuma, every time I try to enter, there will be two angels there with a sword pointing it at me. I will have no power to enter Makkah Mukarrama and Madinatul Munawwara. At that time, Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had an asa in his hand and he was striking it on the minbar 3 times. And he said to the companions, did I not give you the same information well before Tamim Dari had to speak to you? All the companions said, Naam, Naam, Naam. Did I not say to you of the coming of Dajjal? Did I not describe to you of what Dajjal looks like exactly what Hazrat Tamim Dari spoke of? All the companions said, yes. In the hadith here, Asallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Hazihi Tayyiba, look, this is Medina, Hazihi Tayyiba, this is Madinatul Munawwara, in which even Dajjal will not have power to enter. Our sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then gave specification where that island will be. He says, Allah innahu fi bahri sham aw bahri al-yaman la bal min qibal al-mashrik ma huwa aw ma abiyadihi ila al-mashrik, rawahu Muslim. Our sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that this island is near the Syrian Sea, Sea of Yemen, pointing towards the east. In another hadith, our sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, when the Dajjal comes, he will come out from Khurasan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to make amal on what has been said. The fitna of the Dajjal will be very, very powerful. One of the prescriptions given to us so that we are saved from the fitna of Dajjal is to read Suratul Kahf. Every individual should have that habit, at least on a Friday, on regular basis, to read the entire Surah Al-Kahf, and inshaAllah ta'ala, he will be protected from the fitna of Masihud Dajjal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to make amal on what has been said. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. InshaAllah, next week we can talk on the subject of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Du'atullah. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وسلم تسليما لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه نبيك عبدك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه نبيك عبدك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.